Daniel here to talk about the secret to faster DAW export times, and that simply is the buffer size, which is typically set from your audio interface. The buffer size setting dramatically influences the export times, as the lower the size, the longer it takes to complete. Let's test this using an example project with the cycle markers already set. So we go to Studio Setup, and under Audio System, the ASIO driver from your interface will already be selected. So we select Control Panel, which will open up your driver settings. I'm using the Yamaha Steinberg USB driver, but the process will remain the same regardless. We will use three different buffer sizes in this test, representing low, medium, and high settings. We'll start with the low setting by going to 32 samples. Press OK. So let's perform an audio mixdown by going to File, Export Audio Mixdown. We'll use the default settings and export an MP3 and hit Start Cue Export. And I'll skip the export times for the video to keep things moving. So for 32 samples, I've got an approximate reading of 1 minute and 1 second. We'll change the sample size to 256 and repeat the audio mixdown process. Once again, that's going to Studio Setup, Control Panel, changing the buffer size to now 256. Press OK. Go back to File, Export Audio Mixdown, and press Start Cue Export. So 256 samples gives an export time of approximately 27 seconds. So I'll repeat the process again, but with a buffer size of 2048 samples. So just bear with me on that and I'll skip this process. So 2048 samples gives approximately 21 seconds. So in older versions of Cubase, it lacked sample automation precision, meaning that changing the buffer size as we've done could change what you hear if you use automation in your project. In Cubase 12, Steinberg introduced the volume automation precision setting to handle this. By default, it's set to 8 samples, meaning that automation could vary up to 8 samples during the mixdown process, and we would want this as low as possible. Although this project doesn't have automation applied, we will still test the volume automation precision value by setting it to the lowest setting to see if it makes a difference in the export time against the highest buffer size setting, as that's given us the fastest time. So we go to Studio Setup, and this time we click on Audio System and select the volume automation precision value to 1. 1 is the lowest. So we'll hit Apply, press OK, repeat the audio mixdown one more time. 2048 samples, along with the volume automation precision value set to 1, gives us a time of approximately 22 seconds. The difference is negligible. So increasing the buffer size before you export your project and setting the volume automation precision value to 1 should ensure that you hear what you're expecting from the final mix and reduce your waiting times. Like and share if this has been helpful. Take care.